Hello, I'm Simulator Dirk, and welcome back to Train Mechanic Simulator. And we are back in the workshop for our second episode. We had a pretty busy first episode, really, if we want to be frank about it. Welcome to Workshop Wednesday, and we are in the workshop, so we'll get our work order now. The main railway station informed us that a locomotive pulling passenger cars has not arrived on time. Check what happened. Okay. How do I do that exactly? Ooh. Okay, find the derailed train near the coast. That'll do it. So we're going outside. Okay, so outside we go. Exit from the garage. Leave the garage, yes. So we're going outside again, and you can't seem to skip it and say, oh, don't want to do that, that might be a bit too hard. Find the derailed train near the coast. Square E4. Okay, so E. Port Square E4, so that's actually pretty close to us. So if we just keep on going, we don't have to change any points, we will find it. According to this, so here's our recovery loco. So here's our recovery loco. Thank you. we follow this line all the way, we should be able to find the derailed train. It seems strange to say, oh, we don't know where the train is, go find it. And then you go to the work order, and the work order says, well, guess what, the train derailed. Okay, here we go, here's the train of doom. Oh, there it is. Yeah, we found it. Hang on, stop. Press X to start the crane mode. X. Okay. Oh, we've actually got to lift the train. Own the hook towards the grapple mounted on the derailed train. Hang on, where's the hook? Aim the hook. Oh, that's why we've got the crane on the back. Okay. So, W. Hang on, so we've got to extend the arm. Where's the hook? Can we zoom in and see? Okay, so now we go down. Oh, okay, the grapple's over there. Okay, we've got a bit of work to do yet. Bit of height would be nice. Hang on, what I think we might have to do, we'll raise the boom. Oh, okay, so we send the hook down. Now we need to rotate the other way. Now we need to bring the boom back a little bit. We're close enough, we can hitch the hook. We've hitched the hook. Orientation of the train. Okay, what do we need to do now? We need to put the train make it stand upright first of all. We might have to bring the boom up. Up. No, up. A little bit more height, maybe. Might have to rotate it a little bit so we can we zoom out. Yeah, that might be a bit better. Okay, so if we boom up a little bit more height maybe. We got it on its wheels at least. So that's a good start. Once we do that, have a little rest for a minute. And now we'll try and raise. Try and get a little bit of height. I think we have to raise the boom up higher. Give it a little bit more boom, put the boom out. I think that's as much boom as we've got. Oh, here we go. Need to get at the other side of that tree. Actually, we go the other way. it's getting stuck on that tree. Okay, so judging by the shadow next to the locomotive, we need to hang on, we need to put the boom all the way out again. Is that as far as it goes, seriously? Let's give it a bit of height. We need to rotate the loco on the hook. Is that doing anything? Ah, here we go. Yep. So just judging on what I can see on screen, but let me see, rotate. Thank you. See, we've got the added complication of that tree being in the way. Not exactly sure what they want me to do. Thank you. We could be here for a while. Oh no, this is just making it worse. Alright, let's get it high. Let's rotate. We need to rotate the loco now. So off the screen I've been given some distances that I'm trying to acquire. The distance I'm working on at the moment is the angle. Just lowering it so it seems to be the right height. I'm certainly not being helped by that tree. So if we can. If we can clear the tree. That's not helping. That's certainly not helping. Right, our height's good, but No, that's not gonna help. I was not expecting this to be a crane simulator. Right, safely gear. Alright, safely bring it up. Try and rotate it other way. See, we can't extend the boom any further. Here we go. So the rotation's working out. Ah, that wasn't good. So hopefully, try to extend, if we can, give it a bit of height. Maybe we can rotate it around this way, now we're clear of the tree. See, our angle's getting better. Right. So we need to reduce our height now. Good, and now our distance. No, that's going further away. Our done enough. No, that's going further away. That's going further away from where they want it. Oh, the little shadow of where the locomotive is moving. Here we go. Other way. Hang on, we need it a bit higher. Hang on. Way. Oh, that's what they wanted. They actually wanted me to put it back on the track, so I couldn't figure out because of the angle. Okay, so we've done that. So now we can figure out, after all that, how we can get it back to the depot. So if we open our map, we basically have to go around Eastport. You know what? We should be okay, I'm hoping. So we go around Eastport. And then we go towards Westport. So far, so good, our route set for us. Let's have a look. Do you want to finish driving the service vehicle and return to the diesel depot? Yes, I do, actually. Didn't even know that was an option. Instead of doing all that. So here's our poor diesel loco. It appears that the problem is damaged engine mountings in both trucks. Okay, let's get to work. So, engine mountings in both trucks. So, our engine mountings. Engine mountings in both trucks, so in both bogies, in other words. Motor truck. Engine mounting. Alright, our engine mounting, hang on, is 25%. So we've found our engine mountings, so we'll go into disassembly mode. Okay, we've got to get rid of these nuts. So we'll go to our tablet and engine parts. And we'll type in mount. No, okay. Okay, oh, maybe it's regarded as a mechanical part, but it is in part of the engine, but it's a mechanical part. So engine mount, because it's like hardware rather than engine mounting. So we'll need one, two, because we need to do the one at the other end as well. Escape that. We need to assemble. So engine mounting, we need to assemble. We need to select our good one. And Alright, so we're all good there. Alright, so what we need to do now is so that's good. Need to walk to the other end. Can we do that? Okay, we need to go to the other end, because we need to check the one at the other end. Alright, so engine, we're testing, we're in testing mode. Okay, up above. That's our engine mounting. Check the condition. Yeah, that's 16%, that's not good. So we'll go into disassembly mode. Installation mode, put the engine mounting back in, pick out a good one. Now I'm lucky that I played Bus Mechanic Simulator, and the tutorial for that was actually pretty good. So I was able to figure out what the hell is going on. Alright, so we've done that, we've done that. We need to get to our parts warehouse. We need to scrap you. And we need to scrap you. And we need to go back to the work order. Okay, there's one, two, three other things that aren't good yet. So we've done our engine mounting in both ends. So what we need to do now is do a little bit more investigating to figure out what we haven't spotted yet. So this is just going to be process of elimination in and around. We'll start in and around the general area, because there's a few things that we haven't found yet, apparently. Because who knows what was damaged during the derailment. And I'm surprised that I didn't actually ask for a more detailed exam anyway, which is what I wanted to do. I wanted to do a full detailed exam. Which you probably should do a full detailed exam after a derailment anyway. Okay, there's another engine mounting that we need. We need to replace. So we'll go into disassembly mode. What are you? You're an engine mounting. So we need to... find another engine mount. We'll order and we'll put you in. So we'll go into disassembly mode. Can we zoom in? Okay, so engine mounting. I should check the condition of it, because I might need a... Oh, I've got to finish the disassembly, I guess. Testing mode. Yeah, so we'll... So, electric... motor mounting brackets, and it's an engine mounting. Okay, so we'll go to our tablet. Alright. Engine mounting. Electric motor mounting bracket. So we need one of you. Actually, we'll need another one of that. We'll need another one as well. So we can go into disassembly mode again. Some bolts to get rid of as well. Alright, so we need to go into installation mode now. Engine mounting. Select the good one. Throw these back in. Okay, electric motor mounting brackets. One good one, please. Again, it's like the good one. All Alright, so we'll go to our job order now. And there's one more part that we haven't fixed yet. So while we're here, we'll go back into testing mode. And we've pretty much done everything on this side, on this end. I want to finish this end first. It could well be the same thing at the other end. Okay, so everything's looking good at that end. So we'll just go back to the other end. Something here at this other end that we haven't done yet. Oh, this is probably this engine mounting here. There we go. Those engine mounting brackets are actually okay. We'll just complete this. Pretty sure that what we're looking at in red is the only bit that actually needs doing now. To be on the safe side, we'll just check everything. Alright, so our engine mounting, we need to disassemble. Okay, do the tablet. We need another engine mount. Installation mode. Again, pick the good ones. The parts warehouse. We'll scrap you, scrap you, scrap you, scrap you, exit from you, go to. So in the end we had to replace 4 engine mounts and 2 electric motor mounting brackets at the other end. So, bye-bye, and that was good. We managed to finish that. I've been Simulator Dirk, you've been wonderful. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.
Thank you.